guys. I'm coming at you from the top of the crappy obsidian generator here. And I am lagging like crazy still. Jesus Christ. Alright, whatever. Try and make do with what I got. Yeah, I'm part of the shitty computer club. So, yeah, the shitty rotten computer club. If you're part of the shitty rotten computer club, you know, give a like and post a comment being like, yeah, I'm part of the shitty computer club. And say, yeah, yeah, if you're part of it. Because I am. As you can see, I'm staring at these chickens because I'm going to murder these little fuckers. Because I noticed I am almost completely out of arrows. I have 3 left. So I grabbed my flint, some sticks, and some feathers. Or what, 2 feathers that I had. I went over here for a couple hours and I, you know, got the eggs from down underneath. Like that. Holy shit, that's a lot of eggs. Let's just grab these. About a stack and a third worth. A stack in eggs is 16. 1/4 of the normal stack.
There's a bunch more
eggs. Fuck. I almost sacrificed 1 chicken because I'm in creative mode. What a dumbass.
No.
Yeah, I gotta sacrifice 1 chicken because I...
Oh, fuck.
I flew over here in a hurry to try and do this episode and I forgot to turn the game mode back on survival so I could play this damn game.
That's what happens.
Alright, so I spawned a baby one and I killed a baby one. Okay, so that's fine. That's 100%. Get out of the gate! Stupid chickens. Fucking Chuck Dickinson's. I'm gonna murder you asses. Don't.
We got 3 outside.
Her. You know what? Fuck you. Asshole chickens.
Well, they're history now. There's 1 more. It went away.
Ah! There you are. Trying to run from me?
Hey, no feather. That sucks.
Little stingy bastard. Anyway, like you can see, I got a ton of eggs.
Need that.
I don't want to go in there just yet, because when I go in there, I'm going to be swinging my soul.
Well, maybe they'll get the fuck out of the way.
I'll be cutting some fools down.
Well, aren't those the ones that you make for food anyway?
Yeah, these are for food and for feathers. This is the resource pen. This is, you know.
Right.
These guys, are just they're bred to murder. I mean, look at them. They just look like they need to be murdered. Cute little bastards. Anyway. Let's start spawning some fucking chickens.
1 out of all that. 2.
1 out of all that. I hit the other one and he flew over there.
You got 2.
Oh, fuck. Now, I have to be really careful not to kill the baby ones.
Yeah.
Because they'll grow up big chickens.
Well, they're
so.
Half the size. So don't,
got it.
Yeah.
Okay. Now I gotta kill the big ones. You and you. And you, of course. I'm gonna save 1 big chicken, just cause I'm nice. Yeah. Oh, how the fuck?
He got out.
Bastard. Oh yeah. Got him. Yeah, got you. Get you. Hey, what are you doing? Come back here. They call me the chicken chaser. Oi,
oh,
they call you the chicken chaser?
Ah, there's 1 left in the corner.
Boom. I'm gonna leave him or her with all the little chicks. And these 2 fuckers are just camping out. They're like.
Yeah, it must be a female because they're all around her.
And I need to grab the HP and the chicken. Perfect. Just like that. Absolutely beautiful. Okay. Now I have to adjust my video settings because. Alright. Minimum. Particles decreased. Actually, I'm gonna go minimal on particles. Man, my computer is not working properly today for some reason. Usually it's flawless.
There's a lot of people on there.
No, it has nothing to do with that. I'm on single player world.
That's
there, Karen.
True.
I'm not on the multiplayer hubs.
That's true.
Okay, but no, it's. I actually upgraded the graphics and it's working better. Now, what kind of logic is that?
I don't know.
Minecraft logic, that's what.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm gonna throw some more shit over there. Spawn a little baby one. Alright, so I got all them fuckers out of there.
There's a lot of babies in there.
21 feathers and only 14 flint. But that's enough to make me almost an entire stack of arrows.
Yay.
So, yeah, let's go over there and do some fucking arrow.
And if we're going making. To the Nether again, you've got to have arrows.
Yeah, well, we're not going to the Nether again for quite a while because I want to do some stuff on the main base and get this place all nice and tidy. The toucan tree, the reason I have been quite slow at building it, well, for one, it's flipping massive.
Yeah.
And two, because this thing is so big, I can actually incorporate everything in Minecraft I need quite easily inside this massive structure. So,
which ought to be really cool.
So if I do like a redstone like tutorial, which I will do soon, actually I want to start with the redstone this episode on a automatic wheat farm, but I want to do that outside. But when I start getting more heavily into redstone and the mechanics that go along with it, I'm going to be doing it inside the toucan tree. Because I want some, you know, nice lighting structures.
And, yeah, really cool.
You know, some maybe a couple like turrets off to the side.
Right.
You know, the you know, like a defense mechanism.
Right.
In case some baddies decide to get up all on my grill. Alright, yeah, put this there, put that there, and put that there, and well, wait, that there. You have 4 arrows per one of each. So shift click, bam. 59 arrows. So I got 56 arrows out of that.
And be patient, guys. It will turn out to be an incredible tree. But it's just going to take us quite a while. And we'll do other things in between.
Yeah, I've noticed some people, they build like massive spires out of cobblestone and stuff. And it doesn't take them that long. Well, you guys already know why this is taking so long. This is made out of sheer wooden logs. I mean, come on. One of these blocks is like 4 of these planks, okay? So I could make this thing just all the way into space if I wanted to. If I tore down everything and used the same amount of blocks, turn them into planks, and made it built up. So, yeah.
But it's cooler this way.
Oh yeah, it looks like an actual tree.
And it takes time, and it's a lot of work involved. But we add other things into the episode, so it's not all.
Yeah, we take a break. Thing. I try and incorporate things as I go along. This is the Nether chest. I built this one recently to put all my Nether stuff in there.
Cool.
And it incorporates all my Nether crap. Gunpowder. 13 gunpowder. I can build 2 pieces of TNT. That'll be nice. Oh, later on, I want to build a mob spawner pretty soon, actually, and start popping out some buttholes. What I call buttholes are creepers. I'm gonna get some of their poo, and I will start smearing it all over my face and my body, and I'll smell just like a creeper, and they won't attack me anymore. I'm just kidding, guys. I'm just kidding.
But creepers give you dynamite. Right?
They give me gunpowder, which I can turn into dynamite. Dynamites,
right.
Which I'll need dynamite to blow the fuck out of a certain mountain that we visited in, say, episode 2, I think. We saw it and we were like, what do we call this mountain? Episode 2 or...
Ghost Mountain?
Yeah, Ghost Mountain. Actually, it was more like episode 4 or 5. Yeah, it was episode 4 or 5 when I had the, on this direction, I had the little farm set up over there.
Right. Yeah, that was Ghost Mountain. Yeah. That's a weird-looking mountain.
Okay, so, first things first. I got all the feathers, arrows, and all the crap I need.
Okay.
The rest of the episode, I'll be working inside. Alright, let's see here. First things first, I need some, what are they called? Redstone lamps. And what you need for that is a freaking fuck ton of glowstone. And get some redstone out here, just like that. Frickin' fuckload of
redstone
and a frickin' fuckload of glowstone. Now, what you do with the glowstone? I don't use all of it, but you need quite a bit. So I'm gonna make 32 glowstone. You put 2x2 in a crafting table of the glowstone dust, and you make regular glowstone blocks. Put the glowstone in the middle, and you put redstone all around the outside, I think. And I only need it on the north, south, east, and the west, or up, down, left, and right.
There you go.
Bam. redstone lampage.
Booyah.
That saves on redstone. Thank goodness.
Oh, yeah. If it was the other way around where I had it completely surrounded, I'd probably tear my hair out right about now. Alright, so I got 32 redstone lamps, plenty of redstone to power this crap. And I'm also going to need some buttons. Not buttons. Levers. Levers, yes. Because buttons, when you press the button and the redstone is connected to it, it'll turn a circuit on for about 2 or 3 seconds and then shut it back off. But a lever will hold it on. Yeah,
right.
Like a normal switch.
Yep.
In the wall.
Which
okay.
is cool.
Okay, so we need some planks. It's meant for like if you're doing like a if you want something to shut off after the end of the current.
Right.
Like if you're doing like a mob crusher system and you want the sticky pistons to crush the mobs to the point where they're half a heart and
right.
then stop. So you can walk up and just beat them with a piece of broccoli or something and die. And it's like, you know.
Good
like,
old broccoli.
Oh, the broccoli vengeance. Viewers, if you haven't seen that video, go and check it out.
Castle Crashers.
Optional Sunday at Session 2, Castle Crashers. I think it was Episode 1.
You beat a lot of monsters with broccoli. That was fun.
Oh,
as
yeah.
Hell.
That was some good stuff.
That was
Alright,
cool.
guys. Let's see here. I need stone and sticks. I gotta make this fast. So, a cobblestone, viewers. Not stone. Regular cobblestone. Regular crappy old piece of shit
Yay.
Cobblestone. So, I'm gonna make a couple of these. Say, I'm gonna need tons of later on, but I'm gonna make, say, 15, 16 for now. And why not? Let's just make 16 for now, and, I think that's all I need. Do I need a repeater? Do I need to make redstone repeaters? Karen didn't see this, but when I made the lever, really easy. Take a stick and put a cobblestone below it and make a lever.
Oh my god.
Real fucking easy.
That's the easiest thing yet, except for the torch.
Now, yeah, the redstone torch, you already know how to make that. You basically put redstone on top of a fucking stick and you make a redstone torch.
Just like the regular torch.
So let's make a bunch of these because I will need them in the future anyway. So let's make 20 of those. Let's make some redstone repeaters while we're out here. And I need actual stone for the redstone repeaters. Stone. We have 4 pieces.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so I can make 1 redstone repeater right now. Oh, major lag. Woo! That was crazy. Okay, so put 3 stone at the bottom, torch on the middle on either side, and a piece of redstone in the middle, and booyah! Redstone repeater! Good shit. Well, I only need 1 of those for now. I'll go ahead and make a shit ton more later on, but now you guys know how to make them and whatnot. So here's what I want to do. First things first, I want to be able to make the lighting come up. Oh, wait, I need to get my axe out. And I need a lamp here and a lamp here, okay? So I'll go ahead and place the redstone lamps there. And that's going to light up this whole hallway. Now, and I want it switched.
It'll light the hole for you?
It'll light the whole area from this corner to the
Which
back.
Which is your foyer.
Foyer, yeah. Tomato, tomato, all that good stuff. also, let me get rid of that. Give me a lever, and I also want to put the switch, say, right there. That's where I want the switch to flip it on and off to turn these lights on and off, right?
Cool.
So, easy enough, this is probably the most basic redstone you could possibly do. What you need to do is put redstone on the top of these little buggers. Oh, I need to collect that as wood. And just carry on down the redstone. You see it comes on the side of the blocks, too, to carry on the circuit.
Yeah.
And I forget, where was I? Hold on. Dig over here. Ah, I was right there, okay. I forgot where the lever was. Okay, so the lever is right here. So I need to dig this out a little bit so I can get back here. Okay, so let's see here. There we go. Okay. I think I figured it out. What I need to do is come down step by step And end right there. I need to get rid of that block. And I'll get rid of this block so I can jump on top of here. Get zero redstone working. Okay, so redstone travels in lines down, and it only worked for about 15 or 16 blocks before it stops with the current. Then you have to use a redstone repeater faced in the right position of the current, which way you're going from the whatever it is you want power to the switch.
Right.
Not the other way around.
Okay.
So, like, normal circuits, like, if you even know anything about, like, electrical or, you know, like, wiring a plug or something, it basically works backwards. But if I do this, booyah, lightage.
Cool.
Easy enough. Now I have to do this on all four sides. But...
And it really was easy because it runs in its
Now, here's a cool thing. I want to take that off. But here, booyah, still works. As long as it's on that block right there.
Right.
Doesn't matter where you place it. So I'll keep that switch on there. And I will do the rest of this for the other ones. However, I want to start doing the upper level on the next episode. So this has been the redstone tutorial and making arrows and shit with DS2 Can of Karen on Tiddlybits. Yeah, this has been a short episode, guys, but kind of rushed for time, pressed for time and whatnot. I gotta go to work. So I'll see you guys on the flip side. All right.
See you guys later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah!